What's going on, guys? So today we're going to do a complete breakdown and review of 10,000, both their shorts and their shirts, and see how they compare to other popular brands like Nike or Lululemon. Now, quick disclaimer, I am an ambassador with 10,000, but they did not ask or pay me to make this video at all. I just wanted to give my own thoughts and opinions on the clothes. First, let's cover the shorts, because that's kind of what they're known for, that's what they push and market the most, and that's kind of where they stand out. So starting with the shorts, they have three different shorts: the Session, the Foundation, and the Interval. They all have the option to come with a liner, and I'd highly recommend the liner because of how nice it is. It's kind of like a sleek compression, but not too close to hugging your junk or anything like that. It's nice, breathable, comfortable material. It's not a mesh like a Lululemon pair of shorts would have, but it's, like I said, it's more of a compression, but it's super comfortable. It's probably my favorite liner. And the last thing I'll say about the liner is most of their shorts, the Session and the Foundation at least, the liner is like a 3-4 inch inseam, kind of like a boxer brief type length, and I love it. It's phenomenal. On the Interval shorts, for some reason, at least the 7-inch inseam, the liner is almost like a full length compression short where it's almost as long as the inseam and the shorts themselves. And I don't really like that as much. I like the shorter boxer brief style liner, but just my thoughts on that. So starting with the Interval shorts, they are mostly polyester, but slightly spandex blend, more created for all around use. So this is kind of their all around short where you can do running, lifting, athletic movements, anything really in these shorts is what they're aimed at. They got two pockets on the side, a nice mesh material on the inside, so I haven't had any trouble with my keys kind of ripping the pockets like I've had in a pair of my Lululemons where, you know, anything sharp like a key can kind of tear it. This is a nice durable material. Also on one side, on the right side, you have a nice small zip pocket that's really useful actually for holding keys, wallet, credit card, things of that nature. When it comes to the waistband, they have laces on the inside so you can tie it tighter to make it a little more comfortable. But one thing about the Interval shorts specifically, I do not really like the waistband. It's quite flimsy, as you can kind of see. It does mostly hold shape, but it's a little flimsy. The laces don't do a great job at making it snug and a good, great fit to your body. It almost feels like you got shoestrings tied around your waist, and it's not the most comfortable. But if you get the correct size that fits your waist and you don't have to tie it tighter, then you're probably good. I'm the kind of person where I have like a medium or small waist, but my legs need a large, so I went with the size large. But besides the waistband, I really do like these. Like I said, the liner is phenomenal. The material overall is really lightweight, really great for doing different dynamic movements, so they're good for leg day, good for athletic movements, box jumps, different things like that. Super minimal design on these, which I like in clothes. I don't really want anything that's too big and flashy, and that's kind of what they built these around. It's a super sleek, minimal design, small logo on the back right thigh, but overall, simple colors, simple design. They come in a 7-inch inseam and a 9-inch inseam with the Interval shorts. Moving on to the Session shorts, which were my favorite for the longest time. Awesome, awesome shorts for leg days, for running, for anything that you want a shorter inseam. They come in a 5-inch inseam, which is what I have here, but they also come in a 7-inch as well. Like I said, the liner in these is a boxer brief type liner, so it's great. It stays out of the way. It feels amazing. The waistband is also different in these, so it's kind of like a textured hex type design, which I think looks great, and it also feels better than the gripes I had with the Interval shorts. So this waistband feels a lot better. It's the same kind of lace design as far as tightening it, but for some reason it feels better, like I said, and looks better as well. Very similar blend and design as the Interval shorts, just shorter. So you still have these small little slits on the side that serve really more of an aesthetic purpose. Small zip pocket. They don't have any pockets beside the zip pocket, so that is something to keep in mind. You're not gonna be able to fit really a phone unless you have something small. And I have these shorts in black, this light gray, maroon, they have navy, different colors as well. Like I said, my favorite short for the longest time, and really, really look forward to wearing these every time I go to squat, deadlift, anything like that. Just makes me excited to lift. And lastly is the Foundation short, which was a little bit new to me. I was wary to buy them at first, mostly because of the swimsuit type of waistband and drawstring up on the front. But don't let the swimsuit look stop you from buying these shorts. They are my favorite. Like I said, just like the Session shorts, they have that shorter liner, so it's hugging in the right places, good, comfortable, out of the way. And the material on these is a lot more durable and tougher, so these are going to be great for any kind of weightlifting exercises or any workouts where you're really going to rough up your shorts a little bit better. The Foundation shorts are going to be your go-to. So similar to the Interval shorts, pockets on both sides with that nice mesh material, small zip pocket on the right side, great for holding small items. The waistband, again, is a little bit different. So it is a drawstring on the front, like a swimsuit. However, it's a little bit of elastic on the back. So these actually fit a lot better than the interval and even better than the session shorts. So they're more form-fitting around the waist. So these have been my favorite and go-to. Again, same minimal design on the back, which I love. Small logo, great colors, great all-around shorts. These have just been so great to just wear, not even in the gym, but just out and about as well. So these have been my favorite shorts from 10,000. Now moving on to the shirts, they have their distance shirts and their cotton blend shirts. Starting with the cotton blend, there really isn't anything too special about it, if I'm being honest. Like I said, they put most of their marketing research focus into their shorts, so their shirts aren't anything to really write home about, at least with the cotton t-shirt. It's exactly what you'd expect, a nice soft cotton, nothing too special. Hugs the arms a little bit, so if you do weightlift, if you do have some muscle to you, they will probably hug the sleeves, hug across the chest. This is a large, I'm 5'10", 180 pounds. It's really just a great overall shirt. Same minimal design, there's no logo actually on the front or back. There's a small tag on the back, but other than that, there's no logo. Some of their cotton shirts do have a logo across, but they have this with no logo in a gray cotton, they have a charcoal, and then they have two other options, I believe, on the website. And lastly is the distance shirt, which I have in black here. I'm wearing the navy, and this is actually where they impressed me a bit. So like I said, their cotton shirts, pretty basic, nothing really to write home about, but their distance shirts are extremely lightweight. They are 100% polyester microfiber, whatever that means, they are extremely lightweight. So lightweight that you almost forget you even have it on. The colors, they only unfortunately have in black and navy, but I think they look great. Same deal, hug a little bit on the arms and chest if you do have some muscle to you. Again, 5'10", 180 pounds, but they feel great, good length on them, and extremely breathable. So I know I'm gonna be wearing these on any hot day outside as the weather gets warmer in the spring and summer. They're super comfortable. I wouldn't probably wear these in any kind of weightlifting workout just because the material isn't super stretchy. So if I do get a pump or rough it up on a barbell or dumbbell, I don't want to break the microfiber material, but they seem pretty durable. I've had them for a while and they've held up great. And again, it's super lightweight, very comfortable, and I think looks great as well. Same minimal design, no logo, small tag on the back, great shirt overall. So to wrap up this video, I wanted to talk about how do they compare to a premier brand like Lululemon. To prove I have some and have compared them fairly, I have the 7-inch inseam black, more of an all-around short from Lululemon, and also the 5-inch inseam of this little bit lighter material that has a liner inside. These do not. So briefly, I'll compare the liner. Again, the liner in these Lululemons is more of a mesh material. It does stretch a good bit. It is comfortable and breathable, so I will give them credit on that. But I will have to say I prefer the 10,000 liner, especially when it's the shorter liner, like I said, that's in the session and the foundation. Something about it is just a little more comfortable, a little better stretchiness. There is more breathability and space in the ballroom, so if you need that comfort, it's there in 10,000 shorts. It's not a landslide really in either direction as far as liner. But again, what we're looking at is these cost a decent bit more than the 10,000, so how is 10,000 comparable or possibly better is what we're looking at here. Now when it comes to material on both of these, I have to be honest, a lot softer, a lot more comfortable material. I think it's also more durable long term. I've had these for 4 years, maybe even a little bit more, and I've had these for about 3 years, and they've held up. I put them through hell. Especially these, I've worn them at least once a week, maybe twice, three times, and these have both held up. So they have passed the test, they've gone through hell and made it out alive, and again, they're a little bit softer and more comfortable than 10,000. However, like I said, where 10,000 takes the cake is they are a little bit better priced, okay? They're a little bit cheaper. These might run you $40, $45. These are gonna probably run you $60. So you gotta keep that in mind. Like I said, I kind of favor the liner in the 10,000 shorts just a little bit more than Lululemon. Also, it's a design thing. Both are pretty minimal with their logo. They're both on the back end of the short, but cool little waistband here. Like I said, the foundation is a little bit more of a durable material, so they're more made for weightlifters or people that are going through more strenuous workouts, where Lululemon is more made for the runner, the person going to yoga class or cycle class. So you gotta keep that in mind when you're looking at the demographics or populations that they're trying to target as well. So hopefully this video helped if you were considering buying 10,000 clothes or was looking for a more cost-efficient alternative to Lululemon. Hopefully this gave you a better idea on exactly where they're comparable, where they aren't, and about the quality of clothes. Let me know if you guys have any questions about these shorts or shirts from 10,000 down below, and I will be happy to answer them. Again, I do have a code for 10,000, so if you want, you can use code Covington, save 20% off your order. If you found this helpful, make sure you like the video, subscribe to the channel, and I will catch you guys in the next one.